And in this lesson, we'll dig a little bit deeper into digging into some of the scope documents and so forth. So the first phase of general high-level phases are as the course comes in through PIC and so forth, and possibly through either a CDR process or through a PIC approval process. The information comes in generally through into CLI, gets implemented into the project control application. And so as we see, and we just brought up PCAP A10 in the intro lesson, and then we can actually now, one of the next phases possibly is that there's actually a course summit and so forth, and the information through the course summit would actually, as the team is actually assembled, the team is identified to who would actually be invited to the summit. If, in fact, they arrived and attended the summit, there would be a check mark next to each one of the individuals. Over on the left-hand side of the screen, you can actually see some of the higher information of who the developers are, who the dean is, and so forth, program directors, etc. And also, it would actually contain if, in fact, CLI was able to obtain an ARC syllabus. And also CLI is responsible to actually just to look and see if an SME that's actually been assigned to this particular course development has passed OFT. In this case, it looks like yes, back on January 1st, 2011, they did. Yes, there is an ARC syllabus and the date that we have obtained that. And this is the date that the actual course summit occurs on February 23rd. In this case, this is a program, and in a program, you can see Angela is the project manager, is the one that entered this information into this particular application. And through the process, she actually obtained then that this particular engagement with the college is actually an independent development banner/welcome video. Was not full collaboration in the meaning that they did not fully utilize CLI to its fullest capabilities, but actually used it a little bit less of full capabilities. Possibly didn't use banner, or they possibly did not use 3D or Flash, or maybe ID to its fullest development possibilities. Also, as a project manager, the project manager would actually provide additional information into the general and production areas. In this form, you can click on these particular areas and actually scroll down in the areas. Same way with production, same thing, you'd be able to click on here. We can actually then see what the master length is and so forth, and if there's additional weeks involved, would be captured here. Who the main video person is that's assigned to this course, in this case it's Ben. Banner is actually Chad, and ID is actually David. And through the full quality process, looks like Lisa was assigned to this, and the FR was actually held on, was scheduled for July 10th. So this is a particular area of the Scope 1 doc. In here also, you can actually go in. This is actually what's called a form. So this form is actually where the information is actually entered for the Scope 1. And if you want to print the Scope 1, you'd be actually clicking on the Print Record button, which actually then brings up and compresses the data into a particular report. The report can actually be viewed, and you'd go back and forth from page 1 to page 2. On here, you can just see it on the screen, and actually you can also go up and you actually print this report then also. So you'd be actually using the print button and printing out this particular report. And so then if you want to go back to the main screen, which is project entry screen, you click on here and you come back to where we actually started at. And that's the in-depth area of, or high-level area of the Scope 1 doc. Next we'll go into the Scope 2 doc.